Hi guys, this is Jason here from the Nathaniel School of Music, and in this lesson, let's get introduced to the idea of playing glam rock or synth rock, that kind of stuff, also maybe even disco music on the piano. So let's get started. The progression I have for you is very simple, but before I talk about the progression, I just want to talk about how the left hand and how the right hand is going to work. Pretty much in any of these glam rock songs, example, you can take songs like Van Halen's Jump. That could be a good exercise. You know, you'll find the chord moving very rhythmically, at the same time very melodically, okay, in the right hand, while the left hand is playing a very pulsating rhythm following either an eighth note sequence or a quarter note sequence. Okay, so the left hand is generally going to do that. So if you want to do eighth notes, if you wanted to do quarter notes in the left hand, you just play the pulse, but maybe don't play the pulse too long. Like, don't do it too legato, do it more choppy. Since it's rock and roll or rock music in general, play a choppier pulse, one inch, so that you can give way for the eighth note feel, which is very, very common in rock music. So you 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. So create a very drum like approach in the left hand, very percussive approach, 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and. Now if you'd like to also play the eighth note, you could go. See, I don't even have to bring in the right hand, and it's already groovy, right? And then 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Okay, let's go back to quarters. 1, 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. I'm going to be on D major scale for the tutorial. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3. And now let's go to the eighth notes. Slightly faster, right? Rock music is generally at this tempo. 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Okay? And if you do disco music, goes a little bit more faster. That we'll probably get into in another video. Now let's get into the right hand of the piano. So the right hand is pretty much going to just play triads, but very melodically sounding triads. So before we get started, guys, it would be great if you can subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already. And please turn on that bell icon thing for notifications so that any new lesson we bring out will hit you and you won't lose any information. Cheers. So now let's get started. You have the D major scale, and I'm just going to take like the D chord, the G chord, and the A chord, the 1, the 4, and the 5. That's all I'm going to do for the lesson. Yes, you could do a few others, but let's just stick with this for now. So first thing to observe is that every chord you play, or every shape of every chord you play, if you take the D major chord, for instance, and play it like this in the default root position shape, the top note of the chord sort of rings out, doesn't it? This is what the human ear seems to react to or listen to. Even though you have three other notes, it's pretty much that. So if you use this trick to your advantage, now you're putting D out there for the listener. Now you're putting F sharp out there for the listener. So one chord has three notes, and each of the three notes could be highlighted for the listener's ear. Let's do that again. La. Even you should be able to sing that because you're the one playing it for the audience. So you need to train your ear.
La, sing the high note A. La.
That's the D. And then that's the third, F sharp.
La, la, la.
And similarly, you can do the same procedure for the G chord.
La,
ta-ra-ra. That's G, B, D, with the D standing out. B, D, G. D, G, B. And then finally the A chord.
ha ra, A C sharp E, la ra ra, C sharp E, A E C, E A C sharp.
See what's happening? Every inversion, the root position, the first inversion and the second inversion, the top note is actually very melodic in nature. In other words, that is the melody. It's sort of the melody line. So if you focus on those notes and build a melody or a theme around those notes with the chords, I think it can give birth to a very glam rock or a very synthy or a, you know, 80s kind of a sound. So if you take, let's say,
one and two.
What am I doing here? I'm playing A, D, F sharp, which is the second inversion of D, and then the root of A major, which is A, C sharp, E. But for my melodic here,
la da, la da, la da.
And to make the melody a lot more exciting, to make it more rock and more disco and more glam, you can attack a few of the off beats. You don't have to only go with the ons. Now people will think you're just playing chords, but now if you played a little off, and what chords am I using? I'm just using the one chord, D major, the five chord, A major, G major, which is the four, back to the five chord, which is A, and back to D. Okay, so let's try and build like a tune using the chords. Maybe I want to do pa, 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 pa. Pa 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 pa. See, it's a very melodic thing what I just sang. So whatever notes which I sang now could be voiced in the top end of the chord following what I just sang, and then the remaining notes which you're going to play with your other fingers, in this case my thumb and my index finger, will just fill up the blanks. So if it's F sharp, you know that D major has F sharp in it. And also you should choose D major. You probably don't want to choose A major because A major has E, A, C sharp, E, which doesn't have the F sharp note in it. So you can go one, bam. Now I sang E. So what chord goes with E, A major will work. Since I'm limiting my study to the one chord, the four chord and the five chord.
And two and three and four. And I want to sing the high note G there. Bam, E, G, F sharp, E, F sharp, E, D, G, A.
I like that A there. So you go
bam.
Observe how I'm also playing it on the off beat. I've divided the beat by two and I'm latching on to those ands of the bar. Of course, I'm not only playing the ands. I'm also playing some of the down beats and a lot of the off beats so that you feel a little bit of excitement when you're hearing this music.
One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and...
Okay, I hope you got that again.
One and two and three and and one and two and three and four, one and two and three and four.
And another very, very important tip, or a very, very important way to make this sound very, very pro, is to alter the duration of each of your chords. You could say some chords are going to be staccato and some chords are going to be legato. So if I sing, it'll help you the best because you get a very natural flair. Pa, 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 pa. Pa, pa. Maybe every third hit I want it to be long. I'm going to do that on the piano.
One and two and three and four.
Oops, I should have done the third one long.
One and two and three and four. Pa, 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 pa.
And you see what I'm silently doing with my left hand. I'm always feeling the pulse. You don't want to lose the pulse, right? Because that's what your left hand is going to eventually do. I've just sort of waited a bit with the left hand so that we can completely get the right hand. So let's try this out properly. It's just an assortment of the three chords, D major, A major and G major. But I'd advise you to also explore and try to create your own melodic patterns, because this is not too difficult. You could perhaps use the same hit points which I've given out in the lesson and then play your own chords with your own inversions. Like for example, something like that. You'll find a lot of these glam songs or glam rock kind of songs, like Van Halen's Jump, using this technique a lot. Okay, now let's look at the left hand. There's no great rocket science in the left hand. You either can play the pulse. And what's also nice to realize in the left hand, you could just keep the root of the scale. Sometimes this may just work. You can actually play a D root, maybe to get started, and actually it will sound good. See, that's an A major over a D in the bass. And whenever you want to punch out the harmony, then can change the bass. Okay. So essentially I'm doing the pulse, and harmonically or bass wise I'm either playing just the root, in this case D, or I'm playing any of the roots of the actual chord in the right hand. If you choose to just play D, then your chords will be D major with D bass, A major with D bass, G major with D bass. This is a very progressive rock kind of vibe to play like that, or a very glam rock kind of thing used in the 80s. So if you can try that out and then consider moving it around, that'll be awesome. And now another thing you could try in the left hand would be an alternating eighth note sequence between the pinky and the thumb playing root and octave. Let's see how that goes. Just that. Let's go back to the original thing. You could also explore and try out a few other bass notes. B. That's pretty much it. Let's summarize. Left hand playing a very pulse pattern, following the pulse, or else toggling root and octave like a disco feel. And the right hand will essentially take the three chords of the D major scale, which is D major, G major, A major, the 1, 4 and the 5, the positive sounding chords. And then you're trying to express a melody using those chords by highlighting the top note of every chord. Well, you don't highlight it. The chord itself will highlight because of the laws of physics. So the top note will anyways reach out to your own ear as well as your listener's ear. So high D, F sharp. Right, so you have high D, high F sharp, that's high A, and so on. So yeah, have fun playing it, and you don't have to only use a piano tone for this. You could try like an 80s synth, some analog Moog patches which you may have, freak out with some different patch options on your respective keyboards. Okay, so I hope you guys have found that lesson useful. So we've covered a little bit on glam rock, if you will, and some synth rock kind of stuff which made the 80s very popular due to the stuff played on the keyboard. Practice hard, have fun as always, and I will catch you in the next video. If you haven't already, please subscribe to our channel. You could also leave us a comment and tell us if you'd like me to cover something in the future, and also share the video and our channel with all your musician friends, and let's move forward as musicians together. Cheers.